Sharon Ayres, Middlesex Cricket's Participation Manager, joins me here at Gunnersbury Park Sports Hub. Sharon, tonight sees the end of a fantastic women's six-a-side tournament you've been running over this winter.
Oh, fantastic. First one that I've done in the 7 years I've been at Middlesex. The women have really wanted it, and we've had a real problem with indoor facilities. This was built last year. We managed to get a five-week window, so the women have loved it. It's been a fantastic 5 weeks.
I've got to say, I've played a lot of indoor cricket myself, never in such palatial surroundings as these. It's a huge hall. How fortunate are you to get these facilities, and do you need more of this kind of thing around Middlesex?
Yeah, it's unusual. It's unusual, Steve. It's, we've never seen a sports hall this size. To play six-a-side in here, you don't see many double runs in normal indoor, but this makes it more exciting to get the double runs. But we do need more facilities. The women would love to play more indoor cricket in the winter. It'd be a great way to get more girls involved as well, and we just don't have the facilities. This is a luxury.
Women's cricket is thriving in Middlesex at the moment. I've just spoken to Wilhelmina, who said they've got 60-odd women enrolled down at Stoke Newington. Obviously, they've just walked off with a trophy. We had six sides taking part this year in the competition. I guess you're hoping for more next year.
Absolutely. If we could get the facilities, the aim is to come back here or possibly at William Perkins, fingers crossed, when we launch, and then to have another one in the east of London, and then maybe I can have a massive finals day. But women's cricket is growing. We've just finished our audits and numbers are up. Stoke Newington have been running 1 year. They've taken away a bit of silverware, and they're entering two teams into the outdoor league next year. Incredible club, what they've done in 12 months.
Outstanding stuff. Of course, none of this could happen without the work of yourself and the team that are behind you. You've done a bit of umpiring, a bit of coaching, a bit of scoring, a bit of running around, a bit of organising. Often overlooked how much work the participation team do to pull these things together.
Do you know what? We're very lucky. Katie Berry's got a great team together. We've got a massive team of community coaches, group of officers, and then our four managers, and all of us are willing to come down here and get involved. And why not? I've thoroughly enjoyed it over the last 5 weeks. To see this type of talent on show indoors is incredible. It's off the scale. And I can't wait till next year to get it going again.
One thing we've always said about Middlesex cricket staff is there's a degree of commitment there. Obviously, this competition has taken place over the last 5 or 6 weeks. 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock on a Friday night. Damn good effort, I'd say, to get all of you guys here and also all of the teams taking part.
Do you know what? 8 to 10 on a Friday, you think about it in your social life. You think, wow. But remember, we're in London. Travel is a nightmare. These teams would never have got here if we'd said 7 o'clock start. So to be fair, it was that one where we weighed it up, 8 till 10, not very sociable, but actually everybody can get here in less than an hour and get home in less than half an hour. So actually it works out well, even though it's unsociable.
Brilliant. And one last one, Sharon. Obviously Stoke Newington walked off with the silverware tonight. Ickenham second place side, Actonian third place side. Really good standard of cricket tonight and played in great spirit as well. You must be delighted.
I'm absolutely delighted. It's been an incredible tournament. We get no problems with the women. They play it in such a great spirit and the talent was off the scale. Ickenham just losing out tonight. That six with two balls to go from Stoke Newington took the game away. That left her just to a block at the end. It was an incredible game. What a fitting end to 5 weeks of cricket to get that as the last game being the final and go down to two balls to go. Incredible.
Absolutely, a real nail-biter. Well, Sharon, look, well done to you, well done to Stoke Newington, well done to your team, and here's to many more of these.
Thank you very much.